Hello students, welcome back to online English class for Rise 7. Are you ready? Okay, let's go. Before the new lesson today, I want to check you the old lesson. Ở bài học trước, cô đã giới thiệu các em cấu trúc để hỏi về chiều cao cân nặng. Để hỏi về chiều cao, ta có thể hỏi How tall are you? Hoặc What is your height? Hỏi về cân nặng, How heavy are you? Hoặc What is your weight? Và cô đã lưu ý với các em một số chủ từ và hình thức sở hữu của nó. Ví dụ, you thì sở hữu là do, he sở hữu là his, she sở hữu là her. Còn danh từ hoặc tên riêng ta dùng hình thức sở hữu cách. Bây giờ cô có 4 câu hỏi. Các em hãy chuyển đổi những câu hỏi này thành một câu hỏi khác đồng nghĩa với nó. Now you have 1 minute to do the task. Are you ready? Now let's check the answer. How tall is he? Anh ấy cao bao nhiêu? What is his height? Number 2. What is your father's weight? Cha bạn nặng bao nhiêu? How heavy is your father? Number 3. How heavy is Lan? Lan nặng bao nhiêu? What is Lan's weight? Number 4. What is her height? Cô ấy cao bao nhiêu? How tall is she? Let's move to irregular verbs, động từ bất quy tắc. Cô có 6 động từ, các em hãy chuyển đổi những động từ này sang hình thức quá khứ. Have you finished? Now look at the answers. Number 1, be, was, were. Number 2, have, had. Number 3, come, came. Number 4, feel, felt. Number 5, write, wrote. Number 6, see, saw. Now let's begin the new lesson. Unit 11, keep fit and stay healthy. Section B, what was wrong with you? B1. Now look at the picture. This is Mr. Teng and this is Lan. Yesterday Lan didn't go to school. Do you know why she didn't go to school? Okay. Because she was sick. Now look at the dialogue between Mr. Teng and Lan on page 110. To help you understand the dialogue between Mr. Teng and Lan easily, I will give you some new words. Now look at the screen. What was wrong with her yesterday? She had a cold. Number one, have a cold, bị cảm. Next, what was wrong with him? He had a headache. Number two, have a headache. Bị nhức đầu. What are they? They are viruses. Number 3. To have a virus. Bị nhiễm virus. This is a sick note. Number 4. A sick note. Đơn xin nghỉ ốm. Now listen and repeat. Number 1. Have a cold. Number 2. Have a headache. Number 3, have a virus. Number 4, a sick note. Now once more. Number 1, have a cold. Number 2, have a headache. Number 3, have a virus. Number 4, a sick note. Now look at the picture and say. Number 1. Very good. A seat note. Number 2. Well done. Have a headache. Number 3. Excellent. Have a virus. Number 4. Very good. Have a cold.
Bây giờ cô cho chúng ta cùng nhau đi tìm hiểu đoạn hội thoại giữa ông Tân và Lan. Now look at your book page 110 or you can look at the screen. Now listen to me carefully. Where were you yesterday, Lan? You didn't come to school. I had a bad cold. I had a headache too. Oh dear, you were sick. How do you feel now?
I feel okay, but I'm a little tired.
Oh, you should stay inside at recess. The weather's awful today.
Did your mom write a sick note for you?
No, she didn't. But I have this note from the doctor.
That'll be fine. Oh, I see. You had a virus.
I hope you will be okay. Thank you.
To check your understanding, I want you to do the task 2 or 4. Now I have 6 sentences. Now read again the dialogue and decide they are true or false. Now 1 minute for you to do the task. Have you finished? Now look at the answers. Number 1. Lan didn't come to school yesterday. Lan không đi học vào ngày hôm qua. This sentence is true. Number 2. She didn't go to school because she was busy. Lan không đi học bởi vì quá bận rộn. This sentence is false. She didn't go to school because she was sick, not busy. Number 3. Yesterday Lan had a toothache. Ngày hôm qua Lan bị đau răng. This sentence is false. Yesterday Lan had a bad cold and a headache, not toothache. Do you understand? Now number 4. Mr. Tân told Lan to stay inside at recess. Ông Tân bảo Lan ở trong lớp vào giờ ra chơi. This sentence is true. Number 5. The doctor said she had a virus. Bác sĩ nói cô ấy bị nhiễm virus. This sentence is true. Number 6, Lan's mother wrote a sick note for her. Mẹ Lan viết một cái phiếu đơn xin nghỉ phép cho cô ấy. This sentence is false. Trong bài chúng ta có nghe ông Tân hỏi Lan, did your mom write a sick note for you? Mẹ con viết thư đơn xin nghỉ phép cho con phải không? Lan trả lời, no, she didn't, phải không viết. But I have this note from the doctor, nhưng con có cái phiếu này từ một bác sĩ. Thì đây chính là bác sĩ biết cho cô ấy. Now look at the questions on page 110. Now we have 5 questions. Now look at 5 questions. Read the dialogue again and answer. 1 minute for you to do the task. Time is over. Now look at the answers. I. Why didn't Lan go to school yesterday? Hôm qua Lan tại sao không đi học? The answer is because she was sick. B. What was wrong with her? Chuyện gì xảy ra với cô ấy? The answer is she had a bad cold and headache. C. What does Mr. Tân tell Lan to do? Ông Tân bảo Lan làm gì? The answer is he tells Lan to stay inside at recess. D. What did the doctor say about Lan's problem? Bác sĩ đã nói gì về những vấn đề của Lan? The answer is the doctor said she had a virus. E. Who wrote Lan's sick note? Ai đã viết đơn xin nghỉ ốm cho Lan? The doctor wrote Lan's sick note. Do you understand our lesson? Okay, very good. This is your homework. Learn new words. Read B1 again. Repair unit 12 I1. Các em về học cho cô từ mới, đọc lại đoạn hội thoại giữa ông Tân và Lan lần nữa nhé. Chuẩn bị trước cho cô bài số 12 phần A1. Bye. See you again. This is my email.